Get that camera out of my face or I'll break it over your head. Did you hear me? I said get lost.
Maybe you could shoot something else for a little while.
I gotta change the battery anyway.
Sorry if he was bothering you.
It's okay, actually. I'm gonna go to the office. I have to get some work done.
On the 4th of July?
Yeah, it'll be the perfect time to get work done.
Are you sure that's where you're going? I can understand wanting to forget everything that's happened, and Jason and the baby, but you really think going into the sun is going to make it go away?
No, I'm not going into the office to forget about what happened. There's no way to forget. It's always going to be with me.
You blame Jason.
I have my reasons.
But you two have been through so much. I mean, you share a special connection. Don't you think if you tried to get past it all? I mean, you still love him, don't you?
Can I get back to you on that?
I feel like I'm pressuring you too much.
No, I know it's only because you care.
I know all the bad stuff that happens with love. When I think about you and Jason, I guess I just wish I could find a magic wand and wish it all away.
Yeah, that would be great. I wish that too. But when I think about our wedding and how beautiful it was, I can't believe we're not together anymore.
Maybe you can forgive him and find your way back. I know that makes you sound like a hypocrite, so I'm like the least forgiving person on earth.
No, come on, not the least.
I'm gonna keep hoping for you and Jason.
Who knows?
Thank you. Maybe I will find that magic wand.
I'm so glad you're home. Do you know that? Oh, and about that magic wand, if you do find it, you can wave that camera guy around. That would be great. Okay, you were right, Smiley. Yep, no one's here. Okay, he must be off celebrating. I don't know, I'm just gonna look around the office and see if I can find anything that connects Heather to Todd. Okay.
Finding everything you're looking for?
Mr. Manning, I thought you were taking the day off.
Yeah, I don't take days off.
Neither do I. I thought I'd come here and surprise you and straighten up the office, organize your files.
Are you not an American? Shouldn't you be off somewhere planning where you're going to watch the fireworks or watching a really slow parade?
Normally, actually, I would be out doing that. Of the idea of kids and hot dogs and parks and sprinklers. I'm not that into it this year.
Fine. As long as you're here, make yourself useful. Let me know what you think of that.
Balance sheet for Crimson?
Yeah, Kate Howard came by. She's a little peeved that I took her office space. And she asked me to keep Crimson in production. I told her I'd look at the numbers, but that's all like, you know, graphs and pie charts and stuff. And I don't know, you're my assistant. Why don't you do the boring stuff?
Me? Well, I don't know. You're the one who's going to have to be working with her, knowing that she was the one who caused an accident that killed your granddaughter.
Never let personal feelings get in the way of turning a profit.
Well, that's not really for me to decide. But if it were me, I don't know. I don't think I could spend every day side by side with someone knowing that they took away a child I loved. Part of the reason why I wanted this job was to get away from my old life, from the reminders of what I lost and who was responsible.
You're talking about your baby? Did you ever think?
What?
Ah, never mind. You know, I read one of the last stories that the Port Charles Press ran before I bought the paper, and it was about your soon-to-be ex-husband, and I have never met Jason, but, you know, I do feel for the guy, you know, to find out that you have a twin brother and that he's a complete psycho. I mean, I wouldn't know anything about that, right? Franco, that's the name of your baby's father, right?
Yeah, so?
So, crazy rapist, right? I mean, you know, maybe you are better off not having had this kid.
I am not better off without my child.
Well, everything happens for a reason.
No, everything doesn't just happen for a reason. You know what? Maybe it wasn't a good idea to take this job after all.
So what, I've offended you?
What do you mean, have you offended me? You know what, Mr. Manning? I read papers, too. And my baby's father isn't the only crazy rapist. So tell me, do you think your kids would be better off dead because who their father is?
Wait. Please don't leave. I didn't mean to upset you. Look, I'm probably the last person who should be talking to you about your kid. I'm trying to help.
You're trying to help by telling me that my child was better off dead?
Well, come on, how you got pregnant. That's
how
not exactly.
Are you kidding me? Listen to yourself. Stop. You're making it worse.
You're probably right.
Please just stop.
You're young. You're so beautiful. You should just have another kid.
I will never be able to replace the little boy that I lost. Even if I wanted to. I can't.
What do you mean you can't?
This is the second child that I lost. I had a daughter years ago and she was stillborn and this, my son, he was my second chance.
You're right.
I couldn't go through another pregnancy. I would be terrified that something would go wrong. I don't even know how I'm surviving right now, really. My son was my last chance to be a mother, and now he's gone.
I am so sorry for what happened to you.
Thank you, but it's not your fault, so.
There's something I need to tell you.